Okay, Avin's out. Yeah, it's just wonderful. Yeah, very nice. Can we continue? Alright, so naturally I'll meet you guys back when we have the head left. See you there. Okay, we just destroyed that arm. I don't know if you saw that. He's still going to attack the arm, but it'll work on this guy too, I'm sure. Do something. Alright. Alright, so let's do... He'll do the strike sword. And... the rest of us... I'm gonna put anti-magic on some of us. Because you can't heal them when you're... when they have this on them. So I think... Routice. He goes so slow, I'm just gonna put it... I'm gonna have him... Oh, he doesn't have it. Right, right, right. Alright, so... just gonna attack, I guess. No one needs to be healed. So, attack the Sprit of Life. And then... anti-magic on... so, Routice and Mile will have the anti-magic. Yeah, I'm gonna ignore those things. Oh, she just... oh, sheesh, I said. I just gotta ignore those things. He summoned two of them right away. Okay, we're not damaged, so... attack. Deadly. Attack. And deadly. Howl thing. It's not howling, those are like meteors or something. Lasers. Let's call them lasers. Laser attack. Alright, Gawain is completely down. From fully healed. Not working out that well. Routice is gonna have to heal with an item. Or someone can heal her with an item. A full heal. And then a full resurrect. So we just need, well, two people, and one person can attack. So that's going to be Avin. She's gonna heal. Rare rest. And then missing where it is. Here it is. Crap. Vanity? It missed them because they have the anti-magic on. Rarest on Avin. And then I think I'm just gonna put it on Gawain as well. Yeah. Hopefully we have enough to heal ourselves. Oh, Gawain can't cast it, he only has white magic. So, I'm afraid Maya will go too quickly. Well, will not go quickly at all. The anti-quickly. Okay, where am I? I need to find this thing. Anti-magic for Gawain. And then Gawain himself. Complete heal on Avin. And then what was I gonna have you do? I forget. You wanna do a reincarnation on this guy? I don't know why reincarnation is an offensive spell that damages things. Okay, now we got the anti-magic on everyone but Avin. Watch Avin die a lot, I guess. Yeah, it missed everyone else. Okay. We might need to have it on Avin. Zero. What? Oh, it hurt the... Okay, I thought it hit us. It hurt the... It hurt everybody. It hurt all the bad guys, basically. Alright, so we're okay, believe it or not, somehow, with points. Royal powder for Avin. I'm just gonna... A rarer on... Oh, it's not gonna work. Alright, he has to attack then. He's pretty useless in this situation. Attack! Dude, might as well. More reincarnation. Holy strength, destroy evil with your power. That's what he says. Do the Oxide Ring before we bring back Avin. Missed. Missed. Maybe I can damage this thing and destroy these two, because they've been damaged by some of his reincarnations. I don't know. I have her take a rarer. And you can attack. Reincarnation again. Oh, it didn't even heal her up all the way. Oh! We lost some of our... Ah! The two of them lost their stuff. Oh, we never cast on Avin. That's what I meant to do. Oh. Surprised Avin's not dead. Oh, well, he's about to be. That might kill three of us outright. No? Are we okay? Alright. Alright, so we're left with this. The only one protected right now is Gawain. So let's throw a little rarer in there. Miles gonna go too late. And they're gonna kill us. So I'm gonna have to... no, okay. Because he can't cast that. This is a little complicated. Where is that thing? Anti-magic on who? We still gotta bring Avin back as well. We don't have enough people to do all this. Anti-magic on Rutice. And then he can do the Lorera. And let's see if we can do this. He probably won't make it. But anti-magic on... Mile. If we make it, we'll all be anti-magic, and then we just have to bring Avin back and do that for him as well. Okay, Rutice has it up. Not sure if Miles is gonna make it. Yeah, Miles down. I figured that would happen. Alright. They are uninjured. Alright. I guess we'll bring one person back at a time. Should I? I mean, I wish we could start hitting this guy again, but all we do is heal ourselves and bring ourselves back. Royal Powder, Avin. Now what are you gonna do? You might as well bring him back as well. You're not gonna do it that way. We're gonna have to watch Gawain, because his is gonna run out soon. I was trying to have you do this, and you got killed. Try it again. Alright, I don't like her at 115. Rarest on Rutis. You can't cast the thing I want to do. Okay. So I'm going to with her do the anti-magic on Mile. Oh, did Gawain's run out? It might have. I'm not sure where he's standing. And I can't see over this thing. Okay. And I just negated that action to try to see. Okay, anti-magic Mile. And then Rarest. No. Yeah, Rarest on, but she's protected. He can't cast it on her. Oh, this is so complicated. Alright, back out to items. Rarest potion. Matisse. And then might as well go full in, alright. Anti-magic on Avin. Well, there's our answer about Gawain. Now we get to bring him back. Did we kill it? Please tell me we killed it. And there's no more fighting. No more final form. Octum says, "Incredible! Is this true power of the human spirit? It seems they may have finally grown up and should be allowed to become independent." Bartus, I must go first. Emel! Yells Avin. Avin! Emel, you're safe now. There were so many times that I thought that I wasn't going to see you again. Avin, my dear brother, I'm fine. I'm so full of energy. You are? I knew you would rescue me. I know. So, how are you feeling? Do you feel any pain? Did you get hurt? No, I'm really all right. When Octum swallowed me, I was wrapped up by a soft, gentle light. I didn't feel a thing. Really? I wonder what the light was. Rutice says, Avin, congratulations. You finally accomplished your mission. Yes, thanks to you and everyone else who helped me. Emel says, I remember you. We met in Theta, right? You told me my brother was injured. Avin says, this is Rutice. She helped me a lot on my way here. I see, says Emel. Rutice, thank you for helping my brother. And thank you for saving my life. Rutice smiles and says, I'm honored, but I feel a little embarrassed. I just accompanied Avin on part of his journey. Besides, I'm not the only one who helped Avin. Yeah, look around you, will you? It's been 8 years, Emel, says Gawain. Uncle Gawain? You've grown into such a pretty lady. I didn't recognize you at first. I don't blame Avin for making such a desperate effort to save you. Why, because she's pretty? That's his sister. Please, Gawain, says Avin. Emel says, goes, teehee, I know you're just being polite, but I'm honored. And Mile. Good, you're safe too. Thank you so much for coming to rescue me. Mile says, you've endured well, Emel. Avin could continue fighting because you kept your trust in him. I'm truly happy. You two are together again. Mile, she says, you don't look so good. Are you alright? Avin says, yeah, you look so pale. Don't worry, I'm fine. Such a pity, says a man's voice. Hold on. Wow, okay, sorry about that. Such a pity. You need a cane or something? Rutice says, Master Bellius? Avin says, you're still alive? You have done something very stupid. You have taken down one of the gods of creation. Well, it's not like we had a choice in the matter. Avin, the owner of the sacred sword, do you have any idea what you just did? You've destroyed the world's only chance of survival. Avin says, you're right. Octum might have saved the world from destruction, but all he cared about was his own plan for destruction and regeneration. Even if he had saved us from destruction, countless lives would have been sacrificed. That's not right. That's not right. He's like a booty man. There must be some other way to save the world. Taking such chances, Bellius says, that's proof of youth. If I had received the revelation at your age, I might not have chosen this path. But I have no regrets. Master Bellius? Says Rutice. Gawain says, Lord Bellius, what's going on? I told you, I don't miss my life as a mortal. I offered my body to Octum. Well, come on, I don't want to fight you again. If Octum is gone, I must go too. Oh, you mean you're leaving? Okay. Well, there's the door, buddy. Why? Says Gawain. Rutice says, Master Bellius, Rutice, you and I chose to go separate ways. Don't you worry about me now. Avin, no one can achieve his ideals without pain. You'll have to endure pain for what you did. What do you mean? This young man's life had already expired. He was kept alive by Octum's power. What? Says Avin. Oh no. Mile, you knew very well, said Bellius. It's not going to take Mile with him, that you would die if Octum was killed. It didn't matter. I wanted to help Avin. I have no regrets because I got what I wanted. Very well. Human love runs so deep. No, not Mile. Hey, Mile, says Avin. Well, where's Bardas? Can Bardas help him? What's this fog all about? Oh, look, well, look, an energy. Like, haze or something. I'm sorry, Avin. I must say goodbye now. Goodbye? Why? Says Avin. I'm not as smart as you are. Explain it to me. I died a long time ago. I was killed when we were attacked by Lord Bellius on the Holy Capital Highway. But Lord Bellius revived me using the power of Octum. So now that Octum is gone, I must go too. Avin says, no! No! Why? Why didn't you tell me? If I had known, I wouldn't have fought with Octum. That's exactly why I didn't tell you. The purpose of your journey was to rescue Emel, says Mile. Without killing Octum, you would never have been able to do that. I made a promise, remember? I would stick with you all the way to the end. This is the end. Look ahead. Happiness awaits you. What happiness? Where's happiness in a world without you? Mile, don't go. I can't lose you again. Don't worry. You have Emel, he says. Rutis will support you too. You'll be happy. Mile! No! Thank you for showing me who I am. The 8 years with you is my treasure. I'm glad we could travel together one last time. Goodbye, Avin. Turning into a statue or something? No! All he left behind is his bells. Mile. I told you never to lose the guardian bell. Huh. You stupid... You liar! Wah! Did he take the guardian bell? Avin, says Emel. Rutis also says Avin. Gawain says, Bardas, is this a test? I have always believed that the tests you give us are just, that they are meant to make us stronger. But Avin has already been hurt so much, he doesn't need any more tests. It's too cruel. A voice says, Sage, don't blame me. Bardas, I presume? That's the Eleusian sword. Gawain says, oh, you. Rutis says, I feel an incredibly strong presence. It's warm, says Emel. Bardas, says Avin. Son of man, who sealed half of my body. I have seen what you have done since you were entrusted with Cabessa at the beginning of your journey. Avin says, so you've been watching me. You kept surprising me throughout your journey. You taught me the brilliance of the human spirit and strength of love. Thank you, son of man. I didn't do anything to deserve your thanks. I just wanted to protect the people who were important to me. But I failed. I couldn't protect Mile. Rutis says, Bardas, the god of creation of light. I realize I may be asking too much, but please bring Mile back. He and Avin have fought with a do-or-die spirit to defeat Octum and save the world. Gawain says, I ask you as well. Please show them your mercy. Avin says, Rutis, Gawain, I operate on the rules of light. My aim is to maintain order to preserve the world. I cannot act for any other purpose. In this sense, a god is destined to be cruel. However, as a token of my appreciation, I will give you a chance. What? Says Avin. I shall open the gate of Hades once again. Durga's daughter, lend me your power. Yes, says Amel. Song is awesome too. This is the Gate of Hades, an entrance to the world of the dead, which is ruled by Durga. Your friends just fell through this gate. Well, one friend and one fiend. Avin says, can I save Mile if I jump in? I cannot guarantee anything, because you will be bending the laws of destiny. If you fail, you may lose your life too. Son of man, what will you do? Like this any question, I will gratefully take the chance you've given me. Avin, says Amel. Matisse also says Avin. Don't stop me. You've always said I'm impetuous. Well, this will be the last time. I know we can't stop you, Matisse says. But remember, there are people waiting for you. I'm afraid, says Amel. But I know how you really feel. Promise me you'll come back with Mile. Please? Yeah, I promise. Whee! The hell are we going now? Ruti says, believe in him, Amel. Your brother won't be dying here today. He'd better not, Ruti says. Gawain says, Bardas, is praying all we can now? Can do now? Douglas says, hey. And Rail says, is everyone alright? Everybody alright? You run up very quickly. Ruti says, oh, everyone's returned. Lucius says, Rutis, good work. I see our enemy has been defeated. Douglas says, darn, it looks like we were too late. Baron Conrad says, Amel, are you unhurt? Baron, says Amel. Marty says, so you are Amel. Avin told me about you. Mew says, you look lovely. I can't believe you're Avon's little sister. Speaking of whom, I don't see Avin or Mile. Yeah, says Rail. Eleanor says, Rutis, where are they? What happened? Says Archim. Rutis says, Avin went down to Hades to bring back Miles' soul. What? Douglas says. Muse asks, what do you mean? Gawain says, everyone, we must pray for the safe return of Avin and Mile. Amel says, Avin, Mile. Rutis also says, Avin. Ruti says Avin a lot. Avin says, I'm falling. I'm falling all the way. It's dark and cold. Avin says, so this is Hades. The world of the dead, ruled by Durga. Where did Mile wind up? Like he's in outer space now. Ready to puke yet? An old man's voice says, oh my, aren't you impetuous? Lemuris! You even came here. I totally give up. Lemuris, do you know where Mile is? I can't find him. Must I keep falling until I get to the bottom? This is your final test. You must find Mile yourself. Remember the bond between you and Mile. Hold on to that tightly, and you'll be able to save him. Bond. The bond between us. I get it. Haha. Good. You remembered. Goodbye, Avin. I won't see you again. Bye. Thank you, Lemuris. You've always been the source of my wisdom. Alright. I guess he picked that up? I thought it disappeared in front of him. The bell. Aha! Found you! Did you really save Mile? I thought we lost Mile again. Avin, what are you doing here? You lied to me. When we get back, I'm so gonna kick your ass. I can't believe you, says Mile. You're so quick-tempered, reckless, and strong-willed. Thank you so much, Avin. Talk later. Right now we have to get out of this place. Let's go back. Everyone is waiting for us. A voice says, come back. Come back. They're calling us, says Avin. Mile says, these ripples are created by their love. That happens. Archim says, please come back. Marty says, you defeated Octum. You can come back from Hades. Muse says, I won't let you die. I swear on the name of the next queen. Douglas says, you're a formidable pair. Together you can beat any odds. Lucia says, I won't forgive you if you make the girls cry. Rail says, I'm gonna cry too. Please come back. Eleanor says, think about the light on the ground. Think of the high blue sky of Elfilden. Baron Conrad says, get back here this instant. The world needs you. Gawain says, believe in the power of humans, not that of the gods. You can determine your own fate. You are can determine your own fate. ML says, I believe in you, Avin. I know you keep your promise. Ruti says, our journey is not over yet. Please come back so we can continue on. Avin says, I know, Ruti, ML. I can feel all your love. Mile says, people's compassionate love for each other is like a teardrop of life. Each drop is small by itself, but when many gather together, a stream will form and the ripple grows into a torrent. Avin says, when our red flaming tears shine in the darkness of Hades, a miracle will happen. So they could have thought that in the first place about Mile, and he could have come back by himself. Michelle says, you made it, Avin, Mile. Ruti says, ah. Or, ah. Wow, that portrait. Emil yells, Avin. Ruti also yells, Avin. Douglas says, welcome back, you two. Rail says, I knew you'd pull it off. Archim says, I'm really, really happy for you. Bardas? Says Avin. Oh. Lucian. Hey, Bardas, what's wrong? Ruti says, I don't feel any divine spirit from the sword. Emel says, Bardas is gone. He left for a far place in dimension with Octum. Oh, I thought we killed Octum. Emel? says Avin. That voice, says Mile. Spirit Durga. My name is Durga. I'm the first spirit born from the conflict between light and darkness. ML, you've worked really hard. ML says, Durga, it was you. You protected me when I was swallowed by Octum. Thank you. Please do not thank me. I gave you a fated life. Not only to you, but also to the generations of mediums. However, with the departure of light and darkness, you are freed from your fate. ML, you are now free. Hold on, says Avin. If light has also departed, it means Bardas is gone? We only defeated Octum. Light and darkness are one and indivisible. The two gods are parts of the same existence. Because of the magnitude of their existence, they were divided into two and existed separately in this dimension. Humans named them Bardas and Octum. Avin says, but then why have the Bardas Church and Octum's apostles been fighting all this time? Because humans needed gods. Humans are a feeble species that cannot live alone. They cannot form solidarity themselves either. Clear facilities like light and darkness enabled you to unite as a group and live strongly. However, you ended up dividing yourselves into groups of light and darkness and began fighting. Rutis says, I think I understand. The unsatisfied find a false sense of satisfaction in having an enemy. I used to be like that. Durga says, but the era of the gods is now over. Humans must now leave the comfortable shelter of the gods and stand on their own. Right, says Gawain. The person who has the sword ends the long conflict between light and darkness with the mighty shine of his sword. Humans usher in an era of full independence. Michelle says, as Krar said, the prophecy in the scripture came true. But who would have thought it meant our separation with gods? Durga says, I understand you were afraid. You may think of yourselves as a child deserted by the parents. However, you need not worry. With a tear of vermilion, when a tear of vermilion shines, humans grow out of their powerless existence. So that's what the title means? Only they spell it with one L. I think technically I looked it up in vermilion spell with one L, but the game, the outside box says vermilion with two L's, I'm pretty sure, anyway. So I went by that. A tear of vermilion, says ML. Miles says, it sounds very mysterious. It refers to human passion and love. At first, there is only one drop of tear. As it falls between people, however, it starts magical interaction that generates more tears, which soon form a huge current. A strong, massive current that can shake destiny. With it, you can even bring a miracle. Avin says, Durga. Gawain says, are you leaving too? I am the first spirit and gatekeeper of Hades. I will never leave this broken land. However, now that light and darkness have disappeared, I must go back to my eternal sleep. I will wake up one last time when all life has disappeared from this land. Well, then the sleep's not eternal. I wish the day will never come. All right, maybe it will be eternal.